nuclear weapons disposal facility on Shadow Moses Island in Alaska's Fox Archipelago was attacked and captured by Next Generation Special Forces, being led by members of FOXHOUND. They're demanding that the government turn over the remains of Big Boss, and they say that if their demands are not met within 24 hours, they'll launch a nuclear weapon. You'll have two mission objectives. First, you're to rescue DARPA Chief Donald Anderson and the president of Arms Tech, Kenneth Baker. Both are being held as hostages. Secondly, you're to investigate whether or not the terrorists have the ability to make a nuclear strike. Stop them if they do.
What's the insertion method?
We'll approach the disposal facility by sub.
And then?
We'll launch a one-man SDV. After the SDV gets as close as it can, dispose of it. From there on, you'll have to swim. High-tech Special Forces Unit FOXHOUND. Your former unit, and one that I was a commander of.
So they're still around.
There are six members of FOXHOUND involved in this terrorist activity. Psycho Mattis, with his powerful psychic abilities. Sniper Wolf, the beautiful and deadly sharpshooter. Decoy Octopus, master of disguise. Vulcan Raven, giant and shaman. And Revolver Ocelot, specialist in interrogation and a formidable gunfighter. And finally, in charge of them, FOXHOUND squad leader, Liquid Snake.
Liquid Snake?
The man with the same code name as you. The nuclear weapons disposal facility covers the whole island. I'll instruct you by codec after you reach your target.
Anyone going with me?
As usual, this is a one-man infiltration mission.
Weapons and equipment OSP?
Yes. This is a top secret black op. Don't expect any official support. Loud and clear. What's the situation, Snake?
Looks like the elevator in the back is the only way up.
Just as I expected. You'll have to take the elevator to the surface, but make sure nobody sees you. If you need to, contact me by codec. The frequency is 140.85. When you want to use the codec, push the select button. When we need to contact you, the codec will beep. When you hear that noise, press the select button. The codex receiver directly stimulates the small bones of your ear. No one but you will be able to hear it.
Got it. Okay, I'm ready to go. Snake, I'm in front of the disposal facility.
Excellent, Snake. Age hasn't slowed you down one bit.
How's that sneaking suit working out?
I'm nice and dry, but it's a little hard to move.
Bear with it. It's designed to prevent hypothermia. This is Alaska, you know.
Take it easy, I'm grateful. If it weren't for your suit and your shot, I would have turned into a popsicle out there.
An anti-freezing peptide, Snake. All of the genome soldiers in this exercise are using it.
I see. I'm relieved to hear that. Already tested, huh? By the way, how's the diversionary operation going?
Two F-16s just took off from Galena and are headed your way. The terrorist radar should have already picked them up.
Behind D. Colonel, what's a Russian gunship doing here?
I have no idea, but it looks like our little diversion got their attention. Now's your best chance to slip in unnoticed.
There are only 18 hours left until their deadline. You've got to hurry.
Wow, you must be crazy to fly Hind in this kind of weather.
Who's that?
Oh, sorry. I haven't introduced you to yet. This is Mei Ling. She was assigned to us as our visual and data processing specialist. She designed your codec, as well as your Soliton radar system. Contact her if you have any questions about either of them.
Nice to meet you, Snake. It's an honor to speak to a living legend like yourself. What's wrong?
Nothing. I just didn't expect a world-class designer of military technology to be so cute.
You're just flattering me.
No, I'm serious. Well, I know I won't be bored for the next 18 hours.
Come on. I can't believe I'm being hit on by the famous Solid Snake. But I'm surprised. You're very frank for a trained killer.
Looks like we both have a lot to learn about each other.
Yeah. I'm looking forward to learning about the man behind the legend. But first, let me explain about your Soliton radar system. The bright dot in the middle is you, Snake. The red dots are your enemies, and the blue cone shape represents their field of vision.
Be careful, Snake. The genome soldiers have highly developed senses of hearing and vision due to their gene therapy. Make sure you don't let them see you.
First, I want you to infiltrate the disposal site and look for the DARPA chief.
The DARPA chief was injected with the same GPS transmitting nanomachines as you.
He should appear on your radar as a green dot.
Get whatever information you can from him about the terrorists. If he's alive, that is.
Snake, your radar isn't affected by the weather, but if you're discovered by an enemy, you won't be able to use it.
Yes, it gets jammed easily, I'm afraid.
Yes, it's all made from currently existing technology. You won't be able to use it in an area with strong harmonic resonance, so be careful.
We'll be monitoring your movements by radar, so contact us by codec anytime you want.
Got it. I'll call if I'm feeling lonely.
Seriously, Snake, we're here to back you up, so call if you need some information or advice.
I'm also in charge of your mission data. Contact me if you want me to record your current status. My frequency is 140.96. It's a dedicated frequency for saving data. Don't forget it.
Remember, except for your binoculars, you're naked. You need to arm yourself with whatever weapons you can find.
I remember. First, I'm strip-searched by Dr. Naomi here, and then all my weapons are taken away. Imagine yourself put in that position.
Well, if you make it back in one piece, maybe I'll let you do a strip-search on me.
I'll hold you to that, Doctor. By the way, sorry to disappoint you, but I did manage to smuggle out my smokes.
How did you do that?
In my stomach. Thanks to the shot you gave me that suppressed my stomach acids.
Cigarettes? How are those going to help you?
You never know.
If you want to get in, there's the front door. It's the fastest way, but there's too much risk of being spotted by the enemy.
I can't just knock on the door and ask them to let me in. There's one sentry on the left and one on the right. They're armed with 5.56ers and pineapples.
What about the air duct near the door? There should also be a duct on the second floor.
I can't see it from here.
I'll let you decide the best COA. I'm counting on you, Snake.
Surveillance camera?
Been a long time.
Master, what are you doing here?
I quit being a drill instructor, so I moved out here for some peace and quiet. I'm in retirement, just like you. Once in a while, I still help train the Alaskan scouts.
Passing on the skills to a new generation, huh?
Campbell told me about the situation here. I thought I might be of some use.
There's no one I'd rather have in a foxhole than you.
Well, I know lots about survival in a harsh environment. I've lived in Alaska longer than you, so call me if you have any questions about the flora or fauna out here. My frequency is 141.80.
First floor basement.
What about the vent shaft cleaning?
They just opened the vent covers. They're about to start spraying for rats.
First floor basement ventilation shaft.
Shut those covers as soon as they're done spraying. Also, keep your eye on that woman in the cell. Don't get careless now.
Woman in the cell? Did something happen?
There's an intruder.
Really?
He's already done three people.
He's killed three people?
Yeah. Say he's using stealth, too.
Stealth? There's an intruder besides me?
Anyway, I want you to increase the security detail on the chief.
Use the elevator to change floors. There should be a cargo elevator that you can take down somewhere around there. Try to find it.
Radar. It's picking up the DARPA chief. He's the green dot. Hurry and rescue him.
Snake. If you want to go up or down a ladder, just press the action button by the ladder.
Look at the radar. It's picking up the DARPA chief. Snake, are you...
Not him.
To save you. You're the DARPA chief, Donald Anderson, right?
You here to save me, huh? What's your outfit?
I'm the pawn they sent here to save your worthless butt.
true. You don't look like one of them. In that case, hurry up and get me out of here.
Slow down. Don't worry. First, I want some information about the terrorists.
The terrorists?
Do they really have the ability to launch a nuke?
What are you talking about?
The terrorists are threatening the White House. They say if they don't accede to their demands, they'll launch a nuclear weapon.
Sweet Jesus.
Is it possible?
It's possible. They could launch a nuke.
How do they plan to launch? I thought this place was just for keeping the dismantled warheads. They shouldn't have access to a missile.
What I'm about to tell you is classified information. Okay? We're conducting exercises with a new type of experimental weapon. A weapon that will change the world.
What?
A weapon with the ability to launch a nuclear attack from any place on the face of the Earth. A nuclear-equipped walking battle tank.
Metal Gear. It can't be.
You knew? Metal Gear is one of the most secret black projects. How did you know that?
We've had a couple of run-ins in the past. So that's the reason you were here at this disposal site?
Why else would I come to a godforsaken place like this?
I had heard the Metal Gear project was scrapped.
On the contrary, it's grown into a huge joint project between ObsTech and ourselves. We were going to use this exercise as raw data, and then proceed to mass production. If it hadn't been for the revolution...
Revolution?
Rex has fallen into the hands of terrorists.
Rex?
Metal Gear Rex. The code name for the new Metal Gear prototype. Probably already finished arming the warhead they plan to use with Rex. These guys are pros. They're all experienced in handling and equipping weapons.
Hey! Shut up in there, will ya?
But I thought that all nuclear warheads were equipped with safety measures. Some kind of detonation code that you have to input.
Oh, you mean PAL. Yes, of course, there is a PAL. It's set up so that you need to input two different passwords in order to launch the device.
There are two passwords?
Yes. Baker knows one, and I know one.
Baker? The president of ArmsTech.
That's right. Each of us needs to input our password, or there can be no launch. But they found out my password.
You talked?
Psychomantis can read people's minds. You can't resist.
Psychomantis?
One of the members of FOXHOUND. He has psychic powers.
This is bad.
It's just a matter of time before they get Baker's too.
If they find out Baker's password.
Yes, they'll be able to launch a nuke anytime. But there is a way to stop the launch.
What?
The card keys.
Card keys?
They were designed by ArmsTech, the system developers, as an emergency override. Even without the passwords, you can just insert the card keys and engage the safety lock.
And if I do that?
Yes. You can stop the launch.
That card key.
So where are the keys?
Baker should have them. Listen, you need three card keys. There are three different slots to put them in. You need to insert a card into each one of them.
Okay, three card keys. Do you know where they might be keeping Baker?
Somewhere in the second floor basement.
Second floor basement?
I heard the guards say they moved him to an area that has a lot of electronic jamming.
Any other clues?
Yes. They cemented over the entrances, but didn't have enough time to paint them.
Why don't you look for the areas where the walls are a different color?
Here, take this. It's my ID card. It'll open any level 1 security door. It's called a PAN card. It works together with your body's own electrical field.
Personal area network, huh?
It transmits data using the salts in your body as the transmission medium. As you approach the door's security devices, they'll read the data stored in the card.
And the doors will open automatically. Gotcha. Okay, I'm gonna get you out of here.
Wait a minute.
What is it?
You haven't heard any other way to disarm the PAL, have you? From your bosses or anyone?
No.
Are you sure you haven't heard anything?
I just said no.
So does the White House plan to give in to the terrorists' demands?
That's their problem. It has nothing to do with my orders.
But what about the Pentagon?
Pentagon? What is it?
Why?
Hey, what happened?
Naomi, the chief. What happened?
I don't know. It looked like a heart attack, but...
A heart attack? No.
Colonel, are you hiding something from me?
Absolutely not. Snake, you've got to understand. This op is security level red. You need the highest security clearance to get access to the complete file.
You want me to believe that you're in charge of this op, but you don't have complete access to the file?
I told you. The Secretary of Defense is in operational control. I'm just here as your support. Snake, we don't have time to debate. Get out of there and find President Baker.
So you killed the chief, you bastard! Liquid? No, you're not. Don't move!
Is this the first time you ever pointed a gun at a person? Your hands are shaking. Can you shoot me, rookie?
Careful, I'm no rookie.
Liar. That nervous glance, that scared look in your eyes. They're rookie's eyes if I ever saw them. You've never shot a person, am I right?
You talk too much.
You haven't even taken the safety off, rookie.
I told you I'm no rookie!
You're not one of them, are you?
Open that door. You've got a card, don't you?
Why?
So we can get the hell out of here!
Looks like we'll be a little delayed.
What are you doing? Don't think! Shoot! What are you waiting for? Shoot!
Don't talk to me like a rookie!
I'm telling you, shoot!
Thanks for the help.
Wait! Who are you? You fool! You've killed him!
I'm sorry, sir.
His mental shielding was very strong. I could not dive into his mind.
Now we'll never get that detonation code.
Boss, I have a good idea.
I just had some kind of hallucination. Is it from the nanomachines?
No, Snake. The nanomachines are functioning properly.
So what was it?
It must have been psychometric interference coming from Psychomantis, Foxhound's psychic. Think of it as a mental feedback loop.
So that was Mantis.
You caught Snake? Snake, listen to what Lo Chi said. He who knows that enough is enough will always have enough. Just because you see an item doesn't mean that you always have to get it. If you don't really need it, think twice before you stick your neck out. It might not be worth it.
Ah!
Snake, you can't use your radar in that area. There's some kind of electronic jamming coming from there. I wonder what it is. Anyway, be careful. Be careful, Snake.
He's alive. You're the arms tech president, Kenneth Baker, right? Don't worry. I'm here to save you.
No. No, don't touch it!
C4.
Right. Touch that wire, and the C4 will blow up along with the old man. So you're the one that the boss keeps talking about.
And you?
Special Operations Foxhound. Revolver Ocelot. I've been waiting for you, Solid Snake. Now we'll see if the man can live up to the legend. This is the greatest handgun ever made. The Colt's Single Action Army. 6 bullets, more than enough to kill anything that moves. Now I'll show you why they call me Revolver. Draw!
Thank you.
You're pretty good. Just what I'd expect from the man with the same code as the boss. It's been a long time since I had such a good fight, but I'm just getting warmed up.
What? My hand!
Stealth camouflage. Can't you even die right? You were lucky. We'll meet again!
Who are you?
I like you. I have no name.
That exoskeleton.
Talk.
Who are you?
I'm not one of them. The DARPA chief told me he gave them his detonation code. What about yours?
Oh, I get it. Jim sent you. You're from the Pentagon.
Answer my question. What about your code? There's no time.
I talked.
What? Now the terrorists have both codes and can launch any time.
It's not like I didn't fight. I managed to resist Psycho Mantis's mind probe.
He couldn't read you? How'd you do it?
Surgical implants in my brain.
Surgical implants?
Kind of like a psychic insulation. Everyone who knows these top secret codes has it.
Even the DARPA chief?
Of course.
But the DARPA chief said Mantis got his code by reading his mind.
Are you sure you heard him right?
Yeah, I'm sure. In that case, how did they get your code?
I never had any training on how to resist torture.
It looks like he had some fun with you, all right.
Oh, he's not human. I tell you, he loved every second of it.
What happened to your arm?
He broke it.
Looks like you're more than even now. His was sliced off.
Ha, you're a funny man. So the DARPA chief, is he okay?
Dead.
What? I can't be. No, that's not what you promised, Jim! Now you want to shut me up!
Calm down. What's wrong with you? I just told you I was here to save you. I didn't kill the DARPA chief. He had a heart attack or something.
A heart attack? Oh, don't be a fool.
Anyway, the terrorists have both codes now.
Those boys are totally insane. They wouldn't hesitate to launch.
I agree, but what do they really want?
Who knows? Maybe they're like us in the arms industry, always looking forward to the next good war.
Well, I'm not gonna let these maniacs start a war today. You still have the card keys?
Card keys?
To override the detonation code, I heard you had them.
No, not anymore.
What? Who does then? Not the terrorists?
No, that woman.
Woman? Who?
A soldier that was thrown in prison along with me.
A female soldier, it must be.
She said she had just joined up as a new recruit. They threw her in prison because she refused to take part in the rebellion.
A new recruit? Could that be the colonel's niece?
I gave her the key. Looks like she managed to break out of here, though. I hope she's okay.
I'm sure she is. She's green, but as tough as they come. But how did you know she escaped?
I was in contact with her by codec. Until I was tied up here, that is.
Codec?
Yes, she stole it from the guard. If she still has it, you should be able to contact her.
I'm sure she still has it. What frequency was she at?
Oh, yeah. Let me tell you, it's... Oh, sorry. I forgot.
Damn!
Oh, that's right. It should be on the back of the CD case. Try to contact her.
I'll contact her right away. But tell me, if this doesn't work, is there some other way to prevent the missile launch?
You need to find Hal Emmerich, one of my employees.
Who's that?
The team leader of the Metal Gear Rex project. A genius at engineering, but a little bit of an oddball.
If there's anyone who can figure out how to stop Metal Gear from launching, it's him.
What if he can't come up with anything?
You'll have to destroy it. Emmerich knows how to destroy Metal Gear.
Where is this Emmerich?
Well, he's probably being held somewhere in the nuclear warhead storage building. It's north from here. That's where he worked.
I understand, but why Metal Gear? The nuclear age ended with the turn of the millennium.
Oh, you're wrong. The threat of nuclear war isn't gone. In fact, it's greater than it's ever been. The amount of spent nuclear fuel and plutonium is increasing even today. Listen, have you ever seen a warehouse full of nuclear material?
No.
Drums and drums of nuclear waste stacked this high, as far as you can see. Because there's still no real way to dispose of the stuff.
So they just close the lid and try to pretend like it'll go away?
Essentially, yes. And they're not even doing a good job of storing it. Many of the drums are corroded, with nuclear waste seeping out of them.
Unbelievable.
Not only that, but several pounds of muff are reported every year.
Muff?
It stands for material unaccounted for. It proves that there's a large and well-organized black market in nuclear materials. Furthermore, since the end of the Cold War, Russian nuclear engineers in particular are out of work with no way to turn. In other words, there's plenty of available nuclear material and scientists for making a bomb. We live in an age when any small country can have a nuclear weapons program.
What about the other superpowers?
Russia and China still maintain a significant nuclear presence. Complete nuclear disarmament is an impossibility. To maintain our own policy of deterrence, we need a weapon of overwhelming power.
You mean Metal Gear?
Yes. You know our industry suffered quite a blow as a result of the cuts in military budgets due to this so-called peace.
I remember hearing a lot about mergers and takeovers among the big weapons makers.
Yes. And after my company lost their bid to produce the Air Force's next line of fighter jet, the Metal Gear system was our last ace in the hole. That's why we pushed to have Metal Gear developed as a black project.
Black project?
Secret projects paid for by the Pentagon's black budget. You can avoid a lot of red tape and get a great lead time on your weapons production. And no one can bother you. Not even those bleeding heart liberals on the Military Oversight Committee.
Bribes.
I prefer to think of it as good business. Anyway, Metal Gear was going to be formally adopted after the results of this exercise were analyzed.
I don't give a crap about you and your company.
Yes, that's about what I'd expect from a grunt like you. Here, this is what you came for, right?
What's that?
An optical disc. It's all here. The main hard drive was destroyed by gunfire. This is the only remaining copy of the data.
What kind of data?
All the data collected from this exercise. Don't play dumb. I know you were sent to get this. I hid it from that sadistic maniac while he was torturing me. They don't know this disc exists. Make sure you report this to Jim. To your boss. I'll give you my card, too. It'll open up all security level 2 doors.
Can you walk?
No. No, you go on without me. They got my password. They don't want anything else from me.
I have one more question. Who or what was that ninja thing? It looked like you knew something.
That ninja? That was Foxhound's dark little secret.
Dark little secret?
An experimental genome soldier.
You know him?
You should ask Dr. Naomi Hunter from Foxhound. She knows better than I.
Naomi.
You've got to stop them. If it goes public, my company and I are finished.
What? Doesn't Metal Gear use currently existing technology?
Metal Gear itself does, but... What? What did you do to me? Oh, no, it can't be. Those Pentagon bastards. So, they actually went in. Did it?
What are you talking about?
They are just using you for...
Colonel, are you listening? Now he's dead too.
I have no idea.
Don't lie to me.
It looked like another heart attack, but...
Some kind of poison?
Well, there are lots of drugs that can cause a heart attack in large doses. For example, potassium chloride or dioxides, but we won't be able to tell without doing an autopsy.
Damn!
Snake, I want you and Meryl to work together.
Can I trust her?
More than you can trust me. Get in contact with her.
Snake, there's a lot of electrical interference coming from there. It should be okay if you do burst transmission like us, but normal transmission is probably impossible. Try moving away from that area.
Snake, get a hold of yourself.
Naomi, what the hell was that ninja thing? A member of Foxhound?
No.
Are you sure?
Yes, we have no one like that in our unit.
Is that right?
Snake, I'm counting on you.
Snake, you can't use your radar in that area. There's some kind of electronic jamming coming from there. I wonder what it is. Anyway, be careful. Be careful, Snake.
DARPA chief and President Baker. So now the terrorists know both detonation codes.
Yeah, and on top of that, they both died right in front of my eyes.
Snake, now that the terrorists have both detonation codes, the only way to stop a nuclear launch is to either use the detonation code release keys that Merrill's holding, or...
or find the Metal Gear chief engineer that President Baker mentioned, Hal Emmerich.
In any case, you should contact Merrill by codec. Wasn't her frequency written on the back of the CD case?
You called, Snake? Snake, like Shakespeare said.
First the DARPA chief, and then President Baker die of a heart attack?
Yeah, smells pretty rotten to me. Master, do you know anything?
No, but there's definitely something going on. Keep your eyes open out there.
In any case, you should contact Meryl by codec. Wasn't her frequency written on the back of the CD case?
People who have been through war and survived.
Who are you?
I was really impressed with the way you busted yourself out of there.
The one from the prison?
You're the Colonel's niece. Meryl, right?
No, it's not him. Just exactly who are you?
I'm the fool that your uncle sent all alone into the middle of this whole mess.
You came by yourself? You think you're some kind of one-man army?
I don't need lectures. You're just like your uncle, you know?
How do you know my uncle?
We go way back.
What's your name?
My name's not important.
Aha! Could you be Snake? Are you Solid Snake?
That's what some people call me.
The legendary Solid Snake? You? Sorry about before. I wasn't sure if you were one of the good guys.
But I knew you were.
How?
It's your eyes.
My eyes?
They're not soldiers' eyes.
And they're rookies' eyes, right?
No. They're beautiful, compassionate eyes.
Oh, just what I'd expect from the legendary Solid Snake. You trying to sweep me off my feet?
Don't worry. You'll land back on them once you meet me. The reality is no match for the legend, I'm afraid.
Oh, I don't believe that.
Why did you look so surprised when you saw my face?
Because you look just like him.
You mean the terrorist leader, Liquid Snake?
Yeah. You know him? You're not brothers, are you?
I have no family.
So what's the deal, then?
Who knows? Why don't you ask him? But first, I want some information. You were involved in this exercise from the beginning. What exactly happened here?
I'm sorry. I was captured along with President Baker right after the terrorist attack.
That's okay. But what is this place? I don't think it's just a nuclear weapons disposal facility.
boy, oh boy, it's just like them. Nobody told you anything, did they? Okay, you see, this place isn't really for disposing nuclear weapons. This base is owned and operated by a dummy corporation of arms tech.
This is a civilian base?
Right, for the development of metal gear.
Colonel.
Foxhound and the Next Generation Special Forces were called here for the test launching of a dummy nuclear warhead.
Why Foxhound?
Because they're a special ops group used to handling top secret missions. They figured they could help keep it all hush-hush.
But we must have fired nuclear warheads before. Why just this time?
I heard it was because this was to be a final test before the formal adoption of the Metal Gear program. Well, that's what I heard anyway.
Sounds kind of fishy. So what do you think the terrorists want?
I'm not sure. I was captured with President Baker right after the revolt started.
Oh yeah, that's when he gave you the detonation code override keys, right?
That's right.
Amazing you were able to keep him hidden from the guards.
Well, women have more hiding places than men. Anyway, you met Baker, huh? How's he holding up?
He's dead.
What?
Heart attack. Same as the DARPA chief.
The chief died from a heart attack too?
Yeah. Was either of them sick or anything?
No, not that I heard of.
Well, I don't believe in coincidences. Something funny's going on.
Sounds like it, but I have no idea what.
Me neither. Yet. Do you know the person who designed Metal Gear?
You mean Dr. Emmerich?
Yes. Is he still alive?
Probably. He should be in the research lab in the second floor basement of the nuclear warhead storage building to the north.
Second floor basement?
Yeah, that's where his lab is. I think they're forcing him to work on the nuclear launching program.
So they'll need him alive until that's done anyway.
Then we better do something before he finishes.
You're right. In case we can't override the detonation code in time, I need to ask him how to destroy Metal Gear.
You plan to take that thing on by yourself, Snake?
It won't be the first time.
Ah.
What's the best way to get to the building where the doctor is being held?
There's a cargo door on the first floor of this building that leads to the north.
What's the security level of the door there?
5. But it's okay. I've got a level 5 card.
Well, I've got to go save the doctor. You should go.
I'm going with you.
No way. You're still too green. I want you to hide somewhere.
I'm not green.
Oh, yes, you are. You pause for just 1 second in front of your enemy and it's all over. Good luck doesn't last forever.
I don't know what happened. I just couldn't pull the trigger right away. I never had any problems in training, but when I thought about my bullets tearing through those soldiers' bodies, I hesitated.
Shooting at targets and shooting at living, breathing people are different.
Ever since I was a little girl, I always dreamed about being a soldier. Every day of my life, I've trained my mind and body for the one day when I could finally see some real action. And now...
So what now? You want to quit?
I can't quit. I can't allow myself to quit now.
Listen, Meryl. Everybody feels sick the first time they kill someone. Unfortunately, killing is one of those things that gets easier the more you do it. In a war, all of mankind's worst emotions, worst traits come out. It's easy to forget what a sin is in the middle of a battlefield.
But this isn't a war. It's a terrorist action.
You're just a little jumpy from the combat high. The adrenaline in your bloodstream is starting to thin out. Just take it easy.
But I learned all about combat high at the academy.
We'll talk about it later. For now, just think about keeping yourself alive.
If I get out of here alive, I'll think about that other stuff.
Okay. Let me try to say this another way. Stay the hell out of my way.
You're a real bastard. Just like my uncle said.
Huh. I told you. The real me is no match for the legend.
It looks like you were right. Okay, Snake. I'll be a good girl.
We'll link up after I grab the doctor. Then we'll take care of the detonation code override.
Gotcha. But listen, I know this area better than you. Call me if you have any questions.
Be careful, okay?
After I open up the cargo door, I'll contact you. What is it, Snake? Snake? Snake, I unlocked the cargo door for you.
Thanks. Where are you?
Where I can see ya.
Don't move around too much.
Don't worry. I'm disguised in this enemy uniform.
You won't be for long with the way you walk.
What does that mean?
Nothing.
Listen, Snake. The cargo door is like an airlock. It's equipped with infrared sensors. Be careful. If an intruder is sensed, gas is released.
Gas?
Okay, so we'll meet at the nuclear warhead storage building.
Wait, you said you'd stay put and be a good girl.
I changed my mind.
Don't get careless. That's when things always turn sour.
Sorry, but this is the only way I can figure out whether or not I'm cut out to be a soldier. I gotta get my hands dirty.
These guys are professionals. You're gonna get yourself killed.
See you there. Unlock the cargo. We'll be right back. careful, Snake. That airlock is set with infrared sensors. You probably can't see them with your naked eyes, but there are infrared beams coming out of that wall. Touch any one of them, and the doors will seal off and the place will be flooded with poison gas. Somehow, you've got to get through without setting off those sensors.
Snake, be careful. There are claymore mines around there. Use a mine detector.
Who are you?
Just call me Deep Throat.
Deep Throat? The informant from the Watergate scandal?
Never mind about that.
You're not using burst transmission. Are you nearby?
Listen, there's a tank in front of your position waiting to ambush you.
Who are you anyway?
One of your fans.
Mei-Ling, how can someone outside of this operation cut into my codec?
You're talking about that guy calling himself Deep Throat. We were monitoring from here.
What about it?
Well, if somebody knows your frequency, they can call you. But the question is, how did he learn it? It's top secret information.
Can you tell me where he called from?
I'm sorry, the signal is too weak to locate its source. But I'm sure he's near you, somewhere on the base. Careful, Snake.
Thank you.
don't belong in Alaska. I will not let you pass. Send him a message. That's right. You belong on the ground. You should crawl on the ground like the snake you are. Come, let's fight!
What can I do for you, Snake? How's it going, Snake? Have you gotten used to using the radar yet?
See how you like this. boss. I hope you are happy. He got the card.
We'll play with him a little longer.
You would be wise not to underestimate him.
What did you think of him?
He is just as you said. In battle, he is as if possessed by a demon. Much like you, I would expect no less.
See? I told you so, but I will kill him.
So, General Ivan, I hear he took your hand as well as your dignity.
Watch your tongue, Shaman.
In the language of the Sioux people, Sioux means snake. It is known as an animal to be feared.
Well, Snake is mine now. When I meet him next, I'll take special care of him. Not yet. Don't kill him yet.
He and I will meet again in battle.
Same prediction as always?
Yes. The raven on my head. It thirsts for his blood.
You caught Snake? Snake, have you ever heard the saying, friendly counsel cuts off many foes? It means that a little bit of advice from friends can save you a lot of trouble. You should think about it. If you're in trouble or if you need some information about something, please contact Colonel Campbell or someone else, okay?
Absolutely must not use weapons in that area.
I've already programmed the nanomachine so that he won't be able to, Colonel.
What? What are you talking about?
Have you forgotten? That's where they keep the nuclear warheads. Can't you see them?
Yeah, there's lots of boxes piled up here, but are they all warheads?
Yes, they're all dismantled warheads.
They just leave them here? It's like President Baker said, totally careless.
They're working on a limited budget. They try to put on a pretty face for the media, but this is the grim reality of it. Nastasha knows lots more about it than I do. Her frequency is 141.52.
All of the warheads in those boxes have had their detonation mechanisms removed, so there's no fear of them exploding. But if the warheads are broken, they might leak plutonium, and that would be a serious problem.
Snake, never use your weapon on that floor.
Thank you.
What was that noise?
Thank you.
Watch out! That place is filled with gas. Also, the floor is electrified. First, destroy the high voltage switch. It's the switchboard on the northwest wall.
But how? I can't reach it.
Use a remote-controlled missile.
Who are you?
Just call me Deep Throat.
Deep Throat? The informant from the Watergate scandal?
Never mind about that.
You're not using burst transmission. Are you nearby? Who are you anyway?
One of your fans.
You called Snake? In my parents' homeland, they say, If there are more wolves, the people are eaten. If there are more people, the wolves are eaten. That means the side with the greater numbers is usually the winner. You're badly outnumbered, Snake. Try not to let them see you.
Like they were cut by some type of blade.
It's a ghost.
Ha ha ha.
camouflage. Who are you?
Where is my friend?
What? What are you talking about? Oh, what next?
Snake.
You're that ninja.
I've been waiting for you, Snake.
Who are you?
Neither enemy nor friend. I am back from a world where such words are meaningless. I've removed all obstacles. Now you and I will battle to the death.
What do you want?
I've waited a long time for this day. Now I want to enjoy the moment.
What's with these guys? It's like one of my Japanese animes.
I've come from another world to do battle with you.
What is it, revenge?
It is nothing so trivial as revenge. A fight to the death with you. Only in that can my soul find respite. I will kill you, or you will kill me. It makes no difference.
No!
He can watch from inside there.
I need that man. Keep your hands off him.
Now, make me feel it. Make me feel alive again.
Thank you.
Snake, you can't defeat me with a weapon like that.
Snake! You can't defeat me with a weapon like that!
Thank you.
Only a fool trusts his life to a weapon. Snake, you can't defeat me with a weapon like that. That's good, Snake. Hurry up and catch me.
Zanzibar. What? Not again. What's happening?
Gray Fox! Colonel,
That ninja is great, Fox. No doubt about it.
Ridiculous. You of all people should know he died in Zanzibar.
No. He should have died, but he didn't.
What?
It happened before I joined Foxhound's medical staff. They were using a soldier for their gene therapy experiments.
I never heard that.
It happened right after you retired. My predecessor, Dr. Clark, was in charge.
Dr. Clark?
Yes. He started the gene therapy project.
And where is he now?
He was killed in an explosion in his lab 2 years ago.
So what about this soldier?
Apparently, for their test subject, they decided to use the body of a soldier who was recovered after the fall of Zanzibar.
And that was Gray Fox.
But he was already dead.
Yes. But they revived him. They fitted him with a prototype exoskeleton and kept him drugged for 4 years while they experimented on him like a plaything. Today's genome soldiers were born from those experiments.
That's the sickest thing I ever heard.
They used him to test all sorts of gene therapy techniques.
Naomi, why didn't you tell us about this sooner?
Because it's confidential information.
Is that the only reason?
Naomi, what happened to Gray Fox after that?
The record says he died in the explosion.
I see. But even if that ninja is Gray Fox, the question is, why?
From what I could tell, he didn't know who he was.
Are you saying that he's just a mindless robot?
I'm not sure, but he seems intent on fighting me to the death. We'll meet again. I know it.
So you'll fight again? Until you kill him?
Huh. I'd rather not. But maybe that's what he wants.
How long are you gonna stay in there?
Huh? Are you one of them?
No, I'm not. I always work alone.
Alone? Are you an otaku too?
Come on, get out. We can't stay here forever.
Your uniform is different than theirs.
You're the Metal Gear Chief Engineer, Hal Emmerich, right?
You know me?
I heard about you from Merrill.
Oh, so you're here to rescue me?
Sorry, but no. There's something that I've got to do first.
Oh. Well, at least you're not one of them.
Huh. Are you hurt?
I'm okay. I just twisted my ankle a little bit trying to get away.
Well, if that's all, it's nothing to worry about. I want to ask you something. I need information about Metal Gear.
Huh? Metal Gear?
Yeah. What's Metal Gear really designed for?
It's a mobile TMD. It's designed to shoot down nuclear missiles. Only for defensive purposes, of course.
Fire! I already know that Metal Gear is nothing but a nuclear-equipped walking deathmobile.
Nuclear? What are you talking about?
The terrorists are planning to use Metal Gear to launch a nuclear missile. You telling me you didn't know?
They're gonna put a dismantled warhead into Metal Gear's TMD missile module?
Wrong. From the beginning, the purpose of this exercise was to test Metal Gear's nuclear launch capability using a dummy nuclear warhead. The terrorists are just continuing the work you started.
No, you're wrong.
I heard it directly from your boss, Baker.
No. A nuclear missile on Rex?
So you really didn't know?
No. All the armament was built by a separate department, and the president personally supervised the final assembly of the main unit.
President Baker?
Yeah. I was never told exactly what they armed Rex with. I only know it's equipped with a Vulcan cannon, a laser, and a railgun.
A railgun, you said?
Yeah. It uses magnets to fire bullets at extremely high velocities. The technology was originally developed for the SDI system and later scrapped. We were successful in miniaturizing it in a joint venture between ArmsTech and Rivermore National Labs. The railgun is on Rex's right arm.
Metal Gear's main function is to launch nuclear missiles. You sure you're not forgetting something?
It's true that Metal Gear has a missile module on his back that can carry up to 8 missiles, but are you saying it was originally meant to carry nuclear missiles?
Yeah, but that's not all I think. If Metal Gear fired only standard nuclear missiles, then they should already have all the practical data they need.
No. Could it be? Metal Gear's co-developer, Rivermore National Labs, was working on a new type of nuclear weapon. They were using Nova and NIF laser nuclear fusion testing equipment and supercomputers.
So they developed a new type of nuclear weapon in a VR testing lab, huh?
Yes, but you can't use virtual data on a battlefield. They would need actual launch data. These are some of the supercomputers. If you link these, you can test everything in a virtual environment. But it's all just theoretical.
So this exercise was designed to test the real thing.
What did our president do? If the terrorists launched that thing... Damn! I'm such a fool! It's all my fault! The truth is... my grandfather was part of the Manhattan Project. He suffered with the guilt for the rest of his life. And my father, he was born on August 6th, 1945.
The day of the Hiroshima bomb. God's got a sense of humor, all right.
3 generations of Emmerich men. We must have the curse of nuclear weapons written into our DNA. I used to think that I could use science to help mankind. But the one that wound up getting used was me. Using science to help mankind, it's just in the movies.
That's enough crying. Pull yourself together. Where is Metal Gear? Where on this base are they keeping it?
Rex is in the underground maintenance base.
Where's that?
North of the communications tower, but it's a long way there.
The emergency override system for the detonation code is there too?
Yeah, in the maintenance base control room. You'd better hurry. If they were planning a launch from the start, then their ballistic program is probably finished. And since they haven't called for me in a few hours, they must not need me. In other words, they must be ready to launch.
Meryl's got the detonation code override keys. We'll link up with her.
If we can't override the launch, we'll have to destroy Rex. I'll show you the way.
On that leg of yours, you'll just slow me down.
You'll need me if you're gonna destroy Rex.
I don't need you. I just need your brain.
I created Rex. It's my right, my duty to destroy him.
If you get a chance, try to escape. When the coast is clear, I'll contact you by codec.
How am I supposed to escape from an island?
Okay.
So what then?
I want you to hide somewhere and keep me informed. You know this place well, don't you?
Of course I do. And don't worry, I've got this. The same stealth technology as the ninja. FOXHOUND was gonna use them, but with this I'll be fine. Bad leg and all.
Good. But I want Meryl to watch after you too.
Meryl, the engineer's okay.
That's a relief.
I want you to look after him. Where are you now?
Very close.
There she is! Over there!
Oh no! Damn, they've spotted me!
Meryl! What happened?
Something's wrong.
Did you hear something? Wasn't that some kind of music?
What did she look like?
She was wearing the same green uniform as the terrorists.
A disguise?
She had such a cute way of walking. She kind of wiggles her behind.
You were really looking.
Well, she's got a very cute behind.
Way of walking, huh?
If she's disguised as the enemy, you'll have to contact her when she's alone, huh? There's only one place where we can be sure she's by herself.
Where's that?
Don't be so dense. Here, use this security card. It's security level 4.
You're not in pain, are you?
Huh?
You feel okay? Nothing bothering you?
What's wrong? Getting all friendly all of a sudden.
No, nothing. I'm glad you're okay.
You're strange.
I'm a little nervous. Everyone else I've saved suddenly dies.
You're bad luck.
Forget it, Doctor.
Call me Otakon.
Otakon?
It stands for Otaku Convention. An otaku's a guy like me who likes Japanimation. Japan was the first country to successfully make bipedal robots. They're still the best in the field of robotics.
And Japanese cartoons played some part in that?
They did. I didn't get into science to make nuclear weapons, you know.
That's what all scientists say.
I became a scientist because I wanted to make robots like the ones in the Japanese animes. Really, it's true.
Just sounds like a childish excuse to me.
You're right. We have to take responsibility. Science has always thrived on war. Greatest weapons of mass destruction were created by scientists who wanted to be famous. But that's all over now. I won't take part in murder anymore.
Whatever. All I want from you is information.
Sure. I know everything about this whole base. Ask me anything about Rex or about this place. Also, with this stealth camouflage, I can sneak in and out of the armory and mess hall. If you need ammo or rations, just tell me and I'll bring them to you. I'm on frequency 141.12. See you later.
Snake, there's an old Chinese saying, a scholar who cherishes the love of comfort is not fit to be deemed a scholar. Einstein said it another way. He said that only a life lived for others is worth living. That's why I entered MIT instead of Princeton or Vassar like my friends. I wanted to do applied physics, not just theoretical stuff. I wanted to make things for people. The Soliton radar system or the Kodak system. I just wanted to make something that would be useful for people. I think that it was the same for Dr. Emmerich, too. But he was used like a tool, used to make a horrible killing machine. Maybe it would be better if engineers like us just stopped making things. I don't know.